This is John for John Just Beat. I'm at PopCon Milwaukee. I got Dr. Destruction and Lilith Lovecraft. How are you two?
Very good, very good. How are you doing?
Good. You guys enjoying yourselves here?
Absolutely, having a blast.
Now, Doctor, you were telling me about a new venture you got going.
Well, we've been at it for a while, but we're doing overnight radio, midnight to 4 a.m. on AM 1050 WLIP out of Kenosha. That's also streamed at WLIP.com, and we have a four-hour-a-night, Monday through Friday radio program where we talk to all kinds of people that write books on UFOs or film directors and werewolf hunters and all kinds of anything strange and unusual is available on our show, and it's been a lot of fun. My co-host is Lovecraft, does a very, very good wrestling report every night on your latest from pro wrestling. And, I mean, often do you have a girl that does a wrestling report?
I was going to say, how does the wrestling fit in with the strange and paranormal and all that?
Well, you wouldn't believe how strange and unusual the world of wrestling is in itself.
That is true, but, you know, the wrestling kind of falls together. I find a lot of fans of horror movies and horror films and Godzilla movies are also wrestling fans. And as I grew up as a kid and had my little black and white TV with the UHF signal out of Milwaukee, a lot of times I would be looking for, like, you know, they would advertise what Japanese monster movies say would be on a weekend. So I'd watch that station during the week, and they'd have the wrestling shows and roller derby and even the bowling game. Does Milwaukee remember the bowling game?
I remember that.
So, you know, that's what really got me start watching wrestling in the Baron von Reschke era, pretty much. It was a great thing. And then, of course, you know, Milwaukee is famous for horror hosts as well. And Dr. Cadaverino, I was a big fan of him when I was a kid. I had him and the original Sven Gulli at the same time. Later, Toulouse No Neck was on Channel 12. And, you know, I played a lot of clubs up here in Milwaukee. My favorite, though, was probably the Starship, if you've heard of the Starship in downtown Milwaukee. You did have one other horror host before Dr. Cadaverino. He didn't wear makeup or anything, but he was called The Advisor. And the man was actually a lawyer in real life and then introduced the movies. So that's a little bit of Milwaukee history there.
Well, I was going to, okay, so you told me now about your favorite, some of your favorite horror hosts. So you mentioned wrestling. Well, who would be your guy in wrestling?
My favorite wrestler?
Yeah.
Oh, probably the man that made Milwaukee famous, The Crusher.
The Crusher.
Yeah.
And Lilith?
I have to go with my favorite modern wrestler is Will Ospreay. So.
Okay, all right. So where can people find out information about you two?
Well, I guess the best place, where is the best place? So you go to there's a Big Top Radio Broadcast After Midnight Facebook page.
Okay.
And we're still doing the television and everything, but that's probably the best way to find us right there. There's no website or anything like that. But also, there's a film that was released that I'm in, my character is in.
Well, tell us about it.
And that's Killing Pole. Killing Pole was released on Amazon, iTunes, and everything just yesterday. And there's a trailer on YouTube for Killing Pole, or you can go to Killing Pole. And it's a dark comedy about some college students and a vindictive professor, and they wrote my television character into the script.
No
very, very nicely. Yes.
Is that your first movie?
No, it's not my first movie, but it's probably the biggest one I've done.
All right. Well, very nice to meet you guys. I'll let you get back to your fans.
Thank you.
Yep, thank
appreciate
you.
It.